Hello, my friends. Welcome to Trading with KS. So today is 23rd of December 2021. So don't forget, afternoon nowadays, afternoon 12 p.m. Today I post a bit later, around close to 1 p.m. English version, Chinese version a bit earlier, about 12:30 today. Morning got stuck with something. Okay, so remember every day around 12 p.m. I will update the morning session. Okay, morning update. So any a good stock, any strong momentum stock with strong momentum, okay, we will discuss in the morning session. So we got a sneak peek, right, of what is going on into the in the market in the morning, and we also probably can catch a good momentum stock before it go too far Okay, so it's very short. Okay, it's only 10 minutes video today. The English version I managed to do it around 10 to 11 minutes. So also we will talk about the sector, right? Early morning, we want to take a look at the market, whether it's strong or not. Okay, if very strong, then afternoon we got ohm to follow If morning also not really strong, then afternoon probably we don't need to be so focused. Okay, so don't forget, every day, 12 p.m. nowadays, okay, yeah, we have a new video coming. Okay, so check out introduction before. We got a lot of things to talk about. KLCI continue very big spike, but now momentum very low, so maybe I don't know manipulation but still it's up very strong rebound very strong. Okay, check out introduction. Disclaimer: be advised that I'm not a professional trader or advisor. I am sharing my trading journey for entertainment purpose only. Any opinions, news, research, analysis, price, or other information contained in this video is my own opinion and does not constitute investment advice. I will not accept liability for any loss or damage, including, without limitation, to any loss of profit, money, asset, or any valuables which may arise directly or indirectly from use of information in this video. Trading foreign exchange, indexes, stock market, futures, commodities, energy, precious metals, etc. carry a high level of risk, and please trade on your own research and assessment. Please seek advice from a professional financial advisor for your trading needs. Today P-Metal also big jump. P-Metal also big jump. This one KGB also get big contract. Let's check out. For you guys who want to open account, don't forget. You can go to my Facebook or below the YouTube video. Okay, you have the link. You can click the link to open this CGS CMB account, and don't forget support my channel. Okay, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and comment. Okay, let's go into the news today. Quite a lot of news. Okay, quite a lot of news. Even though we are heading to Christmas, look at KLCI. Wow, big jump today. Today only two billion, 2 billion. Volume, easier to manipulate. I'm not saying manipulation happened, but easier to manipulate. Okay, today big push 1516, very strong, 16 point up, 1.03%. These numbers are really shocking. Okay, very good. Singapore up, Santa Claus rally. Santa Claus rally. I have to show you this one again. a lot of you guys bought me coffee. Thank you very much. Florence, Jia, Anthony, Kelvin, okay, thank you very much. I will enjoy my coffee. So Santa rally, Santa come and give you at least can get some coffee money, some present money. Okay, so let's check out the global, what's going on. Singapore up 0.18, Hong Kong up 0.39, South Korea up 0.45, Japan up 0.8, all up Thailand 0.9, Santa rally, Philippines up 1.0, China up 0.9, China FTSE up 0.96, China SSE up 0.57, China SXSE up 0.49, S&P Australia up 0.3, Indonesia up 0.39, New Zealand dropped 0.0, too little bit only. Taiwan up 0.6. Look at Europe, UK also up 0.193. Now UK, the Omicron spread is really scary, a bit scary. UK, that's why they are a bit difficult, UK. DAX German up 0.5, India up 0.59. So very strong rebound. Look at US yesterday, Dow Jones 0.7 up, NYSE 0.7 up, S&P 1.0 up, and Nasdaq 1.179. So really, Senta really, okay, Senta finally, whole year bad, COVID, the COVID pandemic. So finally, Senta come and push the market a bit, So palm oil holding at 4,835 still okay. Brent oil 75 still okay. Crude oil 72 still okay, but not big opportunity yet lah. Gold 1,807 got small rebound. Silver also 22 got minor rebound also lah. Okay, so let's take a close check. Whoa, big push ah. Okay, I said that this one right should go to 1,514, then 1,525 right. Wow, today really boom. One push up now, almost to 1,525 already lah. So here at least got a window to play lah. Even though maybe next few days the price might not continue go straight lah. Maybe some correction. Oh, but I think they already make a uptrend a channel here already lah. So until the price break down from this channel, right, the price will slowly grow up lah. Fast or slow, we don't know. But as long as the price is doesn't close below this line, right, it is. Should be slowly going up lah. So this is our this benchmark lah, our support line lah. Oh, as long as it remain here, we are still confident that the stock market, the KLSE is still rebounding lah. Until it breaks below, then we have to be careful. Okay, so this is where we want to chase it up to 1,525 lah. Okay, so let's check out the so Santa Rally. So today I posted this one Genting rebound okay morning session Genting got some small rebound. We want to take a look later also. I got share that. So don't forget afternoon now I got afternoon video 12 o'clock. So want to buy me coffee? Remember go to coffee.com kyodashfi.com trading with KS okay. All this link in my Facebook my Facebook got all the link Oh my Facebook got all the link. Oh. Need to okay all the link. Maybe I need to put a post at the top there, pin it also with all the link there so you guys easy to find okay. So okay, this one I found this one this welcome post is a very popular Malaysia sub this welcome post welcome post. So I found this 14 or 14 fundraiser for Malaysia that you can donate to aid the flood victim lah. So if you guys want to donate, or you can donate to the Red Crescent Society. All the link is here So this page right, I think it should be legitimate, should be legit lah, should be a real one it's not fake one Sometimes we also get a fake one, but this welcome post is been a very long time lah, so shouldn't be a problem lah. Okay, so we got I will put the link there later below the video lah. So if you guys want to donate. We got a Malaysia Red Crescent, this Mahasiswa Keadilan. All the link is here, bank account, the link or maybe you want to call to verify, maybe this is confirmed, is what is legit one because I follow this site, I found this site, so you guys want to check out also to confirm it's legit or not, but I assume it's legit Malaysia Relief Agency, so the Hope Branch, Muda, Budicare. Happy Bank, Impactive Malaysia, Malaysia Humanity, the People Hero Association, Imarat, MyCare, Global Peace Mission, Mercy Malaysia, these are for clothes one Gembala Kitchen, all these are other things. So you guys can check out here if you want to donate So hopefully we can also can do some help, can help give some helping hand So Gadang sign power purchase agreement to develop solar PV plant with Sabah. So they indirect owns 70% Nusantara Surimas Suriamas Sdn Bhd they signed this power purchase for a large scale solar energy project in Sabah. So NSSB will design, construct and operate solar energy generating facility of 5.9 megawatt in Tawau lah. So this one some good news for Gadang lah. Let's take a look at Gadang lah, see how is it going. Kadang so far nothing much I think, or nothing much lah kadang lah. Kadang is now is a downtrend wedge lah. I think kadang lah once now is a downtrend wedge. Okay, like that. Okay, the wedge like that. Once it's broken now above this wedge, I think it will have a run, but we have to wait for it to break. Still there's no momentum. So we have to wait for it to break 0.405. Then maybe okay, if it had is it will go continue go up, but this one so far nothing to talk, nothing much to talk about yet. 0.405 lah, wait for 0.405. My EG, so my EG leh, become the distributor of a Brie France COVID 19 test lah. These are breath tonic lah. I think using the breath one to test lah. So they are the distributor now. So good for them. Okay, let's see. So they are easy for them to get government this screening project lah. So look at my EG nothing much drop, almost drop to stop loss, but still got pushback. Now RSI go back above 50. I think this one still got chance to go. This one still can hold lah. I think still got chance to go lah. As long as stay above 0.995, I think still got chance to go. 1.9 and 1.19 or 1.25 ah. So Hong Leong investment bank upgrade gaming segment to overweight on improvement outlook okay, so they pick a few. This is very good. Okay, one is they pick Genting, overweight so they are optimistic they pick Genting. No wonder Genting went up today, okay, 6.2. Then he also pick Genting Malaysia 3.61. Also, they also give buy call. All these are buy call. Buy call to Berjaya, BJ Toto, 2.26. Okay, now let's take a quick look. Let's take a quick look today. BJ Toto. Buy call, Hong Leong, 2.26. So this one, haven't make a double bottom. Haven't make a bottom yet. I want to go in. So for now, no more. Not yet. Maybe you want to go in, wait for RSI go through 50 first lah. Or let me see this downtrend a bit difficult. If you buy or the breakout, there's no margin to play. Let me see buy a breakout, no margin to play, 10%. Okay, so this one maybe want to pick bottom, but there's no bottom to pick yet. Okay, you want to pick bottom here, try here. Okay, once the price, if the price can break through, hold about 1.92, maybe, okay, you can try to pick bottom. This one maybe is the bottom. Okay, means, okay, if it go through, right, go through 1.925, maybe this one already is bottom. Means already make a double bottom, triple bottom, or head and shoulder reversal. So once you break through here, I think it can go to this, target really. Possible you can try this target, 16% to Hong Leong Bank, 16%, okay lah. Okay, wait for it to reverse. Once you go to 1.9925, right, I think RSI already break 50, so both should align. Then maybe it's a chance to go in but now not yet I don't see a bottom yet but I see divergence you see price is making exactly the same low, but this one already reverse, so most likely it's going to go up but I want confirmation I don't simply pick bottom, because we know how to see chart we don't invest blindly. I'll just look at the news and invest blindly so we can see the chart. So we want to have some kind of breakout, breakthrough confirmation to give us more confidence to invest our hard-earned money. I also work for 20 years already, it's not it's every money also is hard-earned one. Even though I don't work now, but I used to work 20 years. It's not easy money, Okay, Genting Malaysia so we Genting Malaysia take a look. Hong Leong give Hong Leong give 3.61 So all this I said right, you wait for it to break through. So you see today didn't break through, it went up. Genting Malaysia then went back down, not enough momentum still. We want to see enough momentum, then we only want to go in, because now we got Omicron this and that. So we don't simply jump in, might still come back down. The reason that it haven't go back above 2.8, right, means the institution haven't really go and push. We want the institution come in to push, then only to see the momentum continue grow, then only want to chase the boat, ma. Or don't simply, I mean, I don't see enough, you see, two tail here, you see, all right, one big tail here, one big tail here, means still not enough support from institution for it to continue grow. So this one might still drop, right? That's why we don't want to go in first. Don't worry about these two few percent, okay? We are chasing here, okay? We are chasing this big, big margin here, right? We are chasing this, 30%, Hong Leong Bank 30%, 27%, Maybank 39%, UOB 40%. So we are chasing this. Also, wait for another 1-2, let it go up another 1-2%. Don't need to worry about it, okay? It's not like we are chasing 2%. You go for 1%, then you have to jump in. We are chasing 30-40%. So go up another few percent. Let it push to our confirmation, push to our confidence line first. 2.8, you buy in. Then go to 3.0. Maybe you add. Then we look for all this. So this is aligned, right? You see, right? These are bank all aligned, ma. Bank give all the target all quite high. So means all the bank. If you only see one bank is at $3, one bank is at $2.40, one bank is at $2.80. So this is not aligned, means this one, it's very a bit difficult, for us to plan in the long term, You see this one aligned. You see, right? You look at our chart, our line, right? So some bank give what, right? Some bank give middle channel, right? So it's aligned with our research. Some bank give top channel. Okay, so this is all two good possibility according to the bank and according to our own research. Yes, okay. So this is more aligned, so this is clear, what we want to do. Wait for a proper rebound first, proper break, the price can proper break up, a rebound, stay above 2.88, then only we buy in. It's not too late because we still got so far to go, right? So don't need to hurry in, this one, Genting already went in, Genting already stay above. So this one possible can pick bottom already. Genting Malaysia, unless I haven't go through 50, this is a bit worrisome. So maybe tomorrow, okay, today, yes, it go through 4.6, right? Maybe wait another day for safer, because if tomorrow it drop back down, why I want to say another day? Because you see Genting Malaysia, right, have a big tail here. This is a false break, right? This is not very good, okay? So Genting maybe also we'll have the same fate tomorrow. Maybe we'll have a drop. Okay, then maybe we don't want to go in first. If tomorrow it can hold above, okay, if tomorrow it still can hold above 4.57, then maybe we want to go in and pick one bottom. If it goes higher, okay, maybe you can add at 4-5 ringgit. Also, we are looking at 7. We are looking at around 620, 677, 647 for Genting Malaysia, but only Afin gives so low. I don't know why Afin gives so low, but all the others is giving so high, so our target is around here. Also, this one aligned, right, with our top channel, right? You see, we have a channel over here, right? Channel. So all these are CMB, all these align at the top channel. So we are targeting here, okay? Which both align fundamental and our technical is aligned, because bank use a lot of fundamental, right? So the fundamental is here, our technical is here, so aligned. So we are, okay, we are watching here. Once it can clear properly, okay, stay above our confidence line. So we are going to go in, okay, for this, go in for the queue, right? Okay, so this one looks good. If you go in already, it's okay. If you go in already, it's okay. If you haven't go in, maybe you want more confirmation tomorrow because of this Genting Malaysia, could not go through. If both also go through, then I'm very confident. Maybe wait one more day first. So my news for quarter net loss narrow, it's still lost, but lost a bit less, lost to 8.89 million from 14 million for the previous quarter. Revenue is up, not bad, from 104 million to 93 million to 104 million. So this one also, there's another one news about this one, CGSCMB, still give it good TP, I think give 1.16, ad rating, they're giving ad, means it's doing so it's okay, 1.16, so look at my news, so So Kadanga gives 0.95. So RSB and CMB almost here, 1.2 and 1.16. So this one, when do I want to go in? You see, you got a channel here, right? I want it to go back inside the channel 0.93 only. I will have more confidence to play. Or else it could not, might not be able to. So 20% over, still got 20% over. So I want it to go through this Kadanga price first. At least go through this Kadanga price 0.93. Hold above, then only maybe I want to go in for now. Because this channel, because if you don't, you see the price already got kicked down from the channel one time, right? So so when it come back here, right, it will might still be being pushed down here. So we have to be very careful doing this. So KGB back 110 million contract, a secure 110 million contract undertake. Gas system distribution for Singapore look at KGB. KGB. Okay. So today morning got rebound. You see this one Dajadi, this one is Dajadi. I already draw the line here. This one morning I got talk about KGB because it broke through the line. Then I waited for a while and see what happened, then it dropped back down. So this one not powerful enough. So this one, we got Kenanga 2.5, Afin 1.8. You see, the bank also not aligned, right? So this one a bit difficult, So I look at this, right? Probably still got one. This one a bit difficult to see. Look at the channel, Look at the channel. I think it might want to come down the bottom channel, only rebound is better. Now it's in the now price in the middle of the channel, so still a bit difficult for it to rebound. Then wait and see. Wait for you need to clear out. Need to clear outside the channel first. Stay outside the channel, then only maybe you want to go in. So KMN share over they want to propose asset disposal, so they are having some cash problem, so they want to sell their asset in Thailand, disposing plant in Thailand, UK plant, and listing Germany, this Bossik group, so they want to sell some asset and gather some cash, so KMM take a quick look, KMM. After the big goring here, we managed to chase this goring here, but after the goring all dropped, so nothing much to play, KMM, any rebound, if you're holding high, any rebound, you run. Any rebound you run, that's it. Because this is not any project, they want to dispose asset to get some cash. So Data Prep appointed project delivery partner for COVID-19 test, molecular test, right? So they have received letter from MOH to test run. Good for them. Data Prep, I think I talked about it a few days back, so since today the news come out again, we want to see got goring or not. So many news. Got goring and no goring, Data Prep is still down. So any rebound wave, if you're holding high, run first. So if you want to invest, probably hold above 1.225, then maybe we want to think about it. So COVID go up a bit already, 3,005, I think a lot. Because a lot due to the flood, or the center where people all gather, maybe easier to spread. Expect approve. So this BSN also got this My Ringgit I Banjil scheme. So this one you can, those who get caught with the flood, maybe can approve or can apply for this this scheme from the BSN. And also some stock we don't to talk about today. P-Matter, today big gain P-Matter, so I check the aluminium is very strong lately, we check aluminium first, so aluminium actually reclaimed the channel already, so it went back inside the channel, looks like very strong, looks like possible one more wave up, so that's why P-Matter is very strong, today P-Matter is very strong, PA got nothing, but P-Matter very strong, So P-Matter, I said go through 5.5 can chase, so today already went through 5.5, 5.58. So RSI go through 50 volume big, so UOB got 6.5. So this one can can try. Okay, UOB 6.5. So this one we are chasing how many percent here? Are chasing 17%. Okay. So this one we call it early in the morning. So still got some gain. P matter. Stop loss is here. This one a bit big. Stop loss 5.14. So you talk about stop loss 6%. Okay lah, 6%. We are risking 6% to chase 18% lah. Okay lah, 6% to chase 18%. Triple lah. So we are taking one risk, triple the profit, right? Against three to one risk. Sorry, out suddenly. So what else? MPI, so today MPI morning also got one push up, also got a good volume. So I talk about it, elaborate a bit about MPI in the morning. So MPI still okay lah, still holding. We bought the breakout over here, so we are heading, we are looking for 53 first. If 53 can go, then we looking for 56. Okay, TA gives 64. I think this one a bit too high, so we look for 53 for 56 first. Okay, so continue to hold this one. Looks like still got momentum to push. EPMB this morning also got some momentum to push. So EPMB, okay, continue up lah. EPMB, all that day we look into the breakout over here. It went up a bit, now come back a bit. RSI or still above 50, still okay. Still looks like 1.29. It's trying to break 1.29. A lot of sellers here. Okay, we can go through 1.29, then we'll look for this one, 1.64. But bank also give one level 1.4 here, so you might want to watch out here, 1.4, then 1.64. KGP already talked about it, Genentech. Okay, Genentech haven't rebound, so Genentech have to wait. Maybe making a double bottom here. You want it to go through 40 first. If we cannot go through 40, don't go in first. Not enough momentum. As I said, we want the institution come in to push. Normally, like this, the push like this, right? No institution push, it will be slowly like that one. We want a strong push with volume, go through 40 means institution coming to push, then only we can see, okay, like this, right? The big push right here. We want to see that. Now, don't go in first. Okay, so that's it for today. Remember, subscribe, like, okay, and don't forget the afternoon. Okay, afternoon, I got video, so we can catch the good move earlier than in the evening. Okay, see you tomorrow. Bye-bye.